Public Affairs Broadcasting.
Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning. My name is Nancy Towler. I'm Director of Instructional Programs for Rockingham County Schools. And I have with me today Ms. Erica Blackwell. She's a principal at Dillard Elementary. Ms. Blackwell and I will be telling you about some of the good things going on in Rockingham County Schools and some opportunities that are coming ahead in the future. One thing I want to talk about right away is we're so excited about our students and their science fair. We had a district science fair in January. All 24 of our schools participated in the science fair, and of those winners, 17 of those projects went to the regional science fair. That was held in Greensboro on February 11th. And of the 17 projects that we advanced to the regional science fair, four of those projects are advancing to the state science fair. I'm really proud of those students and excited about their participation and their understanding of science and their ability to convey and present a project to judges. That's going to be at Meredith College in Raleigh the 24th of March. I want to congratulate some of these students. Elijah Velasquez from Reedsville Middle School got first place. And Annie Nye and Cameron Carlock from Moorhead High School are advancing, as well as some elementary students, Isaac Durham, Warren Flint, Colby Garrett from Central, Logan Rakes and Nathan Sackfield from Wentworth. The region was only able to advance 8 projects to the state competition, and Rockingham County took 2 of those projects for elementary. So we're really proud of our students that have advanced to that level, and encourage other students that have not participated in the past to consider doing so in the future. Another big thing that is coming up that affects all of our elementary schools and many families in our county is kindergarten registration. Ms. Blackwell, if you can tell a little bit about kindergarten registration and what particular, maybe what you're doing at Dillard.
Sure, I'd love to. Our kindergarten registration will begin on April the 18th, and go through May 12th. At Dillard Elementary School on April the 19th, we're going to have a very hungry caterpillar night, and that's kind of like an open house for the rising kindergarten students. You all are encouraged to come out to Dillard Elementary School beginning at 6 o'clock on that evening and have opportunities to not only register but also take a tour of the school and meet the teachers and do some great projects with the theme of the Very Hungry Caterpillar. We're excited about it, and it's always a great time for all, so please make sure you mark your calendars. You can go to any of the elementary schools in Rockingham County to pick up a registration packet between April 19th and May the 12th. Early registration is so important, so we'll know how many students to prepare for the fall.
Can you tell a little bit about what parents need to bring for the registration?
Sure.
What documents they might need to get together?
Awesome. Parents, you'll need to bring a birth certificate, a proof of address, and a proof of address is either a water bill or a power bill in that parent's name. They would need a photo ID, which is a driver's license or a passport for the parent, and immunizations, immunization record as well. So there is a kindergarten immunization record. It's good for a year, so if your child, let's say they go to the doctor before it's time for registration to open, you can just take the form to your doctor's office and have them to complete that. You won't have to do a completely new doctor's visit. So, you know, if they've already hit their physical for the year.
Thank you. If you have any questions, you can contact the central office, or you can contact any elementary school. Someone there will be able to answer your questions. Also, I suggest you look on the school website for the area in which you live, and you'll get specific information about any special promotions or special registration nights. But as Ms. Blackwell said, the registration does start April 18th and goes through May 12th. It's really, really important, as having been a former elementary principal, to get all that information up front so you can appropriately plan for the number of classes you need, the resources you need. So if you have any questions, just contact your school or the central office, and we'll be able to help you out with that information. I want to talk about an opportunity for entering kindergartners that's a little bit different than at some of our schools. We have something called SPLASH. SPLASH is a language immersion program. It's a class that you may start in kindergarten, or you can join the class in first grade. SPLASH is, we have two programs. One is called Full Immersion, where you are taught by a native Spanish speaker all day. You come into kindergarten, you're taught your classes in Spanish, with the exception, of course, going to the media center or art, music, PE. And you continue that program on through elementary school. The expectation is you would be fluent, this child would be fluent in Spanish by the end of kindergarten. That full immersion program is at Bethany Elementary. Josh Eanes is the principal there. We've had a kindergarten, first and second grade class. We're getting ready to start our fourth year with that program at Bethany. It's been very successful. We've had a lot of interest. Look on the district website. We will soon be putting our applications out there for entry into this kindergarten class starting in the fall. Last year we had more applicants than we had spaces, so it's becoming to be very popular as students have progressed on through up through the second grade, and we're seeing such positive results. We also have another program at Stoneville. It's not full immersion, it's called dual immersion, whereby the students are taught one day in Spanish and one day in English. And we have also had that program 3 years at Stoneville. And that's also, students are doing well. And if you have an interest in either one of those programs, or you just have some questions, you can contact me at the central office or Mr. Eanes at Bethany. And Casey Pruitt is the principal at Stoneville, and she can answer your questions as well. There is an application process. That application will be online. You can also pick up applications at your school. You can be in any school zone in Rockingham County and participate in one of these language immersion programs. However, parents are required to provide transportation. But once you are accepted into the program, you'll be able to remain at that school throughout elementary school. Students are learning and having a great time about other cultures and languages. And research shows that these students develop critical thinking skills, and certainly the opportunities for being bilingual are great as we become a more global community. We also have opportunities for homeschoolers to participate. We want to reach out and partner with some of our homeschool students. And Ms. Blackwell, would there be anything going on at Dillard that homeschoolers could come and participate in?
Yes, homeschoolers are always welcome to come in and take part in our resource. There is a process for doing that where they can, different days of the week, they can participate in our PE, music, media, and art during quarters that we have art. Also, there are some great things coming up. Our kindergarten through second grade literacy night will be on March the 8th, and we welcome all homeschoolers to come out. The program starts at 6 o'clock. Parents will learn about different ways to help their child in literacy. It will be a make and take opportunity, as well as a wax museum. Our kindergarten, first, and second grade students are going to show off what they've learned about Black history, and they will be in costume and they'll pose as, you know, statues in the wax museum. So that'll be interesting to see. Also, if you'd like to participate, please call the school and make and let us know that, because it's also going to be pizza night. So we want to know how many pizzas to order for the families that are coming. So call and speak with the secretary, Ms. Jones, and let her know how many family members will be attending, and come on out and eat pizza with us and learn great ways to help your son and daughter with early literacy skills.
Yeah, we want to certainly extend that homeschooler invitation to all of our schools. Just as many of the programs Ms. Blackwell talked about that's at Dillard, they are in lots of elementary schools, not extracurricular type activities, but enrichment activities with the media and art, music. Also, middle schoolers have those same sorts of opportunities. Mm-hmm. If you have a homeschooler or you're part of a homeschooling group, contact us at the central office or principals at our various schools, and we certainly would welcome you and encourage you to come and be a part of some of those activities and assemblies that we had.
Ms. Towler, on March the 2nd, the homeschoolers that are interested in just touring the middle school, that's going to be transition night for students moving up to sixth grade. So on March 2nd, beginning at 6 o'clock, the middle school, Western Rockingham Middle School, will welcome all students that are fifth graders. They'll get to tour the school, meet teachers, hear about the awesome opportunities they have there. They have gamers club, wrestling, tennis, cheerleading, all, you know, lots of different opportunities, chorus and band. Homeschoolers can participate in some of those pieces if they wanted to continue on the homeschool track. They could still feed in and participate in some of those areas. And also, it'll be a great opportunity for all families to come out and just get a peek of the school before it's actually time to start and make your sons and daughters feel more comfortable with that transition.
I'm glad you brought up moving up night, because even though she's given the date for the Western Rockingham County area, all of our fifth graders have moving up night to the various middle schools. So contact the school or look on the school's website to find out the date that they're having their moving up nights. And as you say, that's a really good opportunity to get into the middle schools to see what's going on there. We also have something that is sort of a moving up for middle school to high school. There have been some meetings at the middle schools for the rising ninth graders, and to talk about the high school options. We have a lot of options for rising ninth graders and decisions they make as they're leaving middle school to go into high school. Each of our high schools has a focus, and it's an academy. At Moorhead, it's the Health Sciences Academy. At Rockingham County, it's Public Safety Academy. Dalton McMichael, it's the Phoenix STEM Academy. At Reidsville, it's International Baccalaureate or the IB program. And then Rockingham Early College High School is a way that students can successfully map out their coursework, and by grade 13, they will have gotten their associate degree from Rockingham Community College as well as their high school diploma. We are working in a partnership with Rockingham County, Rockingham Community College, and Rockingham County Schools, and we're doing the foundation work of planning for an advanced studies academy. This is going to be a coordination between the faculty at the community college and the school staff, high school staff, whereby students can also map out a pathway. It's going to be a very rigorous pathway, but there is an opportunity to graduate high school with up to 60 college credits.
Awesome.
So you could, theoretically, you could go into college from high school as a college junior.
Mm-hmm.
But that is a rigorous process, but it is a great opportunity for students and families that are willing to persevere and commit to this sort of program. There's a lot of work going on with that right now, and of course more details will be coming out, but I think that is a great opportunity.
It is.
To be able to do that, not only academically for students who can handle that rigor, but also financially.
Exactly.
For parents, because if anybody's paying college tuition, you know what getting 2 years off of that would mean to families.
Right.
So I think now it's a good time to go to break, and we'll be with you in a few minutes.
WLOE Eden. WMYN Mandan. Listen online all the time. RockinghamCountyRadio.com.
Okay. Ms. Blackwell's going to talk to us a little bit about the reading bug and what that is and what you get to do with the reading bug.
Okay. The reading bug is held on April the 1st. It's a Saturday beginning at 9 o'clock a.m. at Rockingham Middle School. All of the elementary schools in Rockingham County, they come together and they prepare a literacy table, and it's themed based on a childhood book. And at that table, parents pick up tips on ways to work with their child. It's a make and take opportunity. Students, they interact with reading. Sometimes it will be through technology, digitally, and other, you know, sometimes it'll be a writing process. So please come out. It's always a great time to explore all the tables and participate in the make and takes. And that's going to be on April the 1st, beginning at 9 a.m. at Rockingham Middle School in Wentworth.
I believe they've had a lot of authors to come in, and okay. Yeah, food.
Yes, they do.
Lots of activities that day. It's a lot to do. It's fun for all ages of children.
Mm-hmm.
And they get lots of treats and books and things yes. As being a participant in that. I want to talk a little bit about our gifted program in Rockingham County. That's one of the areas that I work with. We have begun implementing a new plan. Every 3 years, we are required to develop and submit a new plan to Department of Public Instruction. And so we are on that new plan. There's some changes in how we identify students and how we are serving our students. The identification is a little more rigorous than it's been in the past, but it's a little more in line with our surrounding districts. We've gotten some feedback from parents and teachers and administrators, and for the most part, they are well pleased with the changes we've made. However, we're always looking for additional feedback. If you have a child that is part of that program, or even if not, and you have some questions or some suggestions, we certainly welcome those. Mm-hmm. There is a formal process for being identified. There are multiple pathways to identification. It's a lot on test scores and student performance. We really are working hard to develop ways to serve underrepresented populations because there are lots of students that may possess gifted qualities that are not demonstrating those in the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
We serve elementary and middle services as well as high school. In high schools, there are honor courses that any student can take. There are advanced placement courses. There are courses where you can demonstrate your success and skills and content knowledge as you prepare for college. The AP or advanced placement course, those exams are in the spring. And if you get a qualifying score for your the college you want to attend, which would be a score of a 3, 4, or 5, then you get college credit for that course that you've taken in high school. And again, this goes back to a benefit not only academically, but for paying college tuition. North Carolina Department of Public Instruction pays for the AP exams. In the past, students and families and schools have helped pay for that. I think that's an $86 fee that you no longer have to pay. So I would encourage you, if your student is interested in academic rigor and is planning to go to college, to seriously consider taking AP classes. I know you have a student in college, I believe,
I do.
And you may can speak to some things that he's done that's been successful, or...
Well, he took 2 AP classes in high school, and he passed, and sure enough, those were 2 that he did not have to take, and he received college credit for that, so that that helped out a lot, because you know we want him in and out in 4 years.
That's a good way to get a head start. We also, for our gifted students, we have a governor's school, and students apply for governor's school. There's a rigorous application process. We have a committee at the district level that screens those applications and send those on to the Department of Public Instruction. Then they let us know. We have not found out yet which students are have been accepted, but every year we have students that are accepted. Mm-hmm. And the tuition for that is paid by the McMichael Foundation. So we're very thankful for that community group that makes this opportunity possible for our students. Any student can participate in the Academic Challenge Competition. It's called the ACC. Each of our five high schools have ACC teams. They practice throughout the year. We have had our second round of meets. Each high school competes against every other high school. There's a math, English, science, social studies, and then all around category. And it's sort of a quiz bowl type atmosphere where questions are called out and teams have an opportunity. Now, last night I was at the meet between McMichael and Rockingham County High School. Going after the first four rounds, McMichael was ahead, but during the toss-up questions, Rockingham came back strong and ended up winning by just a very few points. It was very exciting, and so we go through that process, that ACC challenge, throughout the these months, February and March. And at the end of that, and we have determined all of our winners, there is an awards banquet. And we are we celebrate the students' achievements, and we are happy to say that Tri-City Motors sponsors that. They pay for that banquet and that celebration for the students. Mr. Sam Coates from Tri-City Automotive Group also gives awards and scholarships to students that night. So that's another great partnership we have in our county. We have Battle of the Books. We have an elementary Battle of the Books and a middle school. This year we have 10 elementary schools participating. It's only the second year that elementary have been involved. We've had one preliminary round. We have two more. Our final competition will be at the school board room at the district office in March. It's an exciting time where students are given a list of books at the beginning, and they read the books. They meet with their coach after school or maybe in the mornings to talk about books, ask questions about the books. And so then when there's a competition, the competition is about questions on the books from that reading list. It promotes reading. I know I heard one little boy said he's read every book twice. He's very excited about his participation. We also have the same thing for middle school Battle of the Books. All four of our middle schools participate. That's been a longstanding activity here in Rockingham County. And that competition's at the central office on March 14th. Do you have any special reading programs or anything going on at Dillard that promote reading, Ms. Blackwell?
We have an AR program, and we also have some reading literature circles that many of our teachers are doing connected to standards. Our students receive incentives for reading. So we do a lot to encourage reading in the classrooms. Many of our students, they are part of classroom trains as they get different word lists, and that's always exciting. But I'm sitting here thinking we have great partnerships and so many awesome opportunities in Rockingham County Schools. And so I'm glad that we're here to share all those different opportunities with you all today.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure you get the question a lot, what can I do to help my child at home with reading? So I think our most standard answer, which is probably still a wonderful answer, is read with your child.
Exactly. Read and ask questions. At Dillard, we give out little bookmarks with question stems so that you can, you know, it's great to ask those, who was in the book, what happened, but there are some other questions that you want them to get into with inferencing, and why do you think, what do you think that character was thinking if you were in their place. So I encourage you to talk with the reading specialist at your child's school or the principal and ask them, are there other questions that I should be asking my child? Because comprehension is a big piece as well. Just making sure that as the child is reading, they're comprehending and they're understanding, having those discussions about the book and making sure you have a time each night that's pressure free and just a time to enjoy the reading process.
Mm-hmm. You really cannot underestimate the power of reading with your child.
Right, you know,
and
you cannot.
That impact. We have another opportunity for students. It's called Credit by Demonstrated Mastery. It is where students are able to earn credit by demonstrated mastery of a subject or content area without sitting through the class. Mm-hmm. There are two phases of that. The first is a test, and if you get a particular score or above, then you have a project to do to demonstrate you understand that. This is great for students that may have a background, say, in Spanish, and may be bilingual or may speak Spanish at home. They may take this Spanish test, get that high score, have a project to demonstrate their understanding of Spanish 1, and then get credit for Spanish 1 without taking the class. Mm-hmm. This is available for any student. That we give the testing 3 times a year. In February, we're wrapping up this round. We'll do it again in the summer and then again in the fall. So if you are really strong and have a deep understanding of a particular subject or content area, you can talk to your counselor at your school, and you can get additional information, or you can give me a call at the central office to share that information, because it's a great way to earn high school credit without sitting through the coursework. Again, I want to thank you for being with us this morning. Ms. Blackwell, thanks so much for coming and joining
me.
And I'm Nancy Toller again, and my number at the central office is 627-2649. You can give us a call for questions, comments, or suggestions. Thank you.
Thank you.